Good morning, students, and assalamu alaikum. Today I am going to take you your English lesson. Please take out your language tree book. Okay, open page number 11, unit 2. I have mentioned the page number on the board. I have mentioned the unit name, historical report. Take out this page. Page number 11 of your language tree book. So today our topic is historical report. I wanted to know, do you know the meaning of historical and have you ever heard the word report? Okay. The word historical is related with history. It means past events which have been already done, which is in the past. And the word report, it means that you have to collect a kind of data related to some topic. So you have to write a report on it. You have to collect some facts and figures about the person or place or any event which is held in the past. What is report? I'm writing on the board so that it could be clear to you what is historical report. Historical report is collection of specific topic to write an essay. Likewise, report is always written about past things. Report is always written about past things or events. And it should be related to history. And it could be any event, person, or community. So first of all, you all have to understand the meaning of report. What is report? Sorry, collection of specific things to write an essay. It could be any facts and figures that you have to collect about the topic which has been given to you to write the report. Report is always written about past things which has already happened in the past. It is written about those things. It should be related to history. You cannot write about the present, like the ongoing situation, the coronavirus. You cannot write about report on it right now. After 5 to 10 years, you can be given the topic, the COVID-19. Then you can write the report on it. For example, if I give you a topic like 9/11, or I can give you write a report on Qaid-e-Azam. These are the things on which you can write the report. You can collect data about Qaid-e-Azam, about his life, about his work, about his struggles, what he had done for Pakistan. You can collect those data and you can write a report on it. And likewise, it can be any event in the past, like 9/11 or the World War, or it can be about any community, about their history, like Christians or like Hindus, their history. So you can collect the data about them and you can write a report on it. Now, what is written in this chapter is First of all, I will ask you a question at the end of the lecture, that how is your life different from the life of your grandparents who lived when they were your age? Like, you have to compare your life and your grandparents' life, that how it is different, how it was different before 60 years and how the life is different right now we are living here. And what things do you have that they did not have? Means like gadgets. Today we have a lot of gadgets. Today we have computer, mobile phones, smartphones, everything. And in the history, in the past, these things were not available. In the past, people used to do their work by themselves. And now we are here. We have maids and servants, and people do the things. So while I'm reading the chapter, you have to compare and contrast the things, that how your grandparents' life was different from your life, or how your life is different from your grandparents' life. Now, this is a non-fiction report. Report is always non-fiction. What is non-fiction? Any one of you know the meanings of non-fiction? At the end of the lecture, I will ask you about it. Non-fiction is based on reality. You know, the things which are real, which are done in the reality, those are called non-fiction. Means which are original things, original events, or anything that happened originally. Real little piece of here. You know, the real things. These are called non-fiction. Now, early morning, 60 years ago, the report which we are reading in this unit is 60 years ago. It has happened before 60 years. So, it is about past. The people who were living in the past, what were their what their work to do, what they do, how they spend their life, what were their main objects, and how they spend their life, or how they spend their day. So I will start reading. 60 years ago, Hamza and Taha were young boys in Karachi. Most mornings they consumed parathas and fried eggs for breakfast. Now, the meaning of word consumed is eat, or to take. The meaning of word consumed is eat. So here are 4 to 5 characters in this chapter. Hamza, Taha, their elder brother, Khalid, their father, mother, and their sister, Amina. These are the characters of this chapter. And the setting of this report is in the past, 60 years ago. Now, what they are doing, Hamza and Taha are the young boys. They are living in Karachi, and they take their morning breakfast, like parathas and eggs as usual. And now you have to compare what you take in the breakfast. Okay, and where do you live? And how many siblings do you have? You compare these things accordingly. Like I'm reading this chapter. What you eat in the breakfast? They eat pratas and eggs. What do you eat? Today we eat like egg and bread, and we can take tea, we can eat biscuits, we can... They are different people and they have different choices. So you as a person, what take in a breakfast while before coming to school, you have to think that in your mind. I will ask you the question at the end. Sometimes they eat boiled eggs. Sometimes they eat only boiled eggs, no prathas and nothing else. Before they went to school, they had to do chores. Now, this is very important. Before they went to school, they had to do chores. Chores, the meaning of chores is a routine task, especially household one. Household works like cleaning, cooking, washing, these are household tasks which we call chores. So before they go to school, they had to do the household work. So do you do the household work at home before coming to school? No, I don't think today's children do their household work before coming to school. So you have to compare that, okay, equally in your mind that when you come to school, before you come to school, what do you do? We don't do household chores and our mothers do that stuff. We just have our breakfast, get ready for the school and come to school. So the life was very difficult before, in the past, in the history. They had to do their work by themselves and then they have to get ready for the school and then they come to school. But today, we just wake up, get ready for the school, take our breakfast and come to school. So this is the difference between them and today's children or today between us. So turn the next page. Page number 12. Hamza began by drawing water from the well for the day's washing, cleaning and cooking. Now this is interesting. Hamza used to pull the water from the well. In today's life, we don't have wells. We have underground motors. We just switch it on, the water comes. In past, they had to draw the water from the wells. So this is another contrast and comparison in today's life and from the past. They had to collect the water for washing, cleaning and cooking. Now what is the meaning of drawing? Drawing means to pull or to drag. What does drawing means? To pull or to drag. Hamza has the duty to drag or pull the water from the well for the whole day, washing, cooking and cleaning. Now what was Taha's job? Taha's job was to cut potatoes using a knife to make vegetables for lunch. He has to cut the vegetables for lunch in the morning before going to school. So they don't have to butter the knife themselves. After coming from the school, they had to cook their lunch for themselves. But today, in today's life, when we go home, our lunch is ready and it is made by our mother. But in the past, these boys had to do their work for their lunch as well in the breakfast. So they cut the potatoes for their lunch. The boys did their jobs while their sister. Now, I have told the job of Hamza and Taha. Now, what is the job of their sister? Her name is Amina. The boys did their job while their sister Amina was ironing the school clothes. Now Amina had to iron the school clothes for her and for her brothers. But now compare it with yourself, that do you iron your clothes by yourself? No, no one of you iron the clothes by yourself. Your mother does that, or any your sister, elder sister or your maid. So these people do your jobs. But in the past, they had to do their work by themselves. So compare and contrast these things with your life. Okay, how she irons the clothes. In today's life, we have iron. We just switch it on and we just start doing the ironing of our clothes. But they had to do the iron. Like they had to put five heavy iron set on a hot plate over the fire. There is a fire area where they have to put the five plates accordingly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when the one plate turns hot, she takes the plate and she irons. And when the plate turns cool, she takes another iron and she does so the work. Five heavy irons set on a hot plate over the fire. When they were all hot, Amina used one to iron clothes. About 2 minutes, it grew cool. So she put it back on the hot plate and picked up a hot one. So like I have told you, when the one cools down, she had to keep it and then she take the another one. So she went on putting down on cool iron and picking up a hot iron. So she does the same thing until or unless the clothes are being ironed. Now they had one another brother, older brother. His name is Khalid. What does he do? Their older brother Khalid often went fishing with their father at night. The next morning, he scaled and cleaned up pomfrets and prawns, which his mother later sold from a table by the beach. Now, their older brother Khalid go fishing with his father at night. And the next morning, they have to, their mother sell that fishes at the beach table. Now, the meaning of scale. Scale means covered of scales. There are small scales on the fishes which are being removed. So they clean that scales, pomfret. Pomfret is a kind of fish. And prawns. These 3 to 4 things they had to sell from the beach table, which are being sold by their mother. Their mother had the gift. So, because their mother is selling these fishes at the beach in the morning, so the boys and their sister had to do the household work. So, compare this with your life. Does your mother do any kind of job or any kind of work? After this job, Khalid always smelled of fish. And he had to take a bath before school, or the teacher would send him home. Now, there is some kind of fish thing or fish smell. When he is spending his whole time with the fishes at night, so in the morning he smells like the smell of fish or he stinks. So he had to take bath regularly before going to school, because if he smelled with the smell of fish, the teacher used to send him home back. Like if you come to school, you are stinking or you have any kind of smell of fish or any other thing. Teachers get really annoyed. So they send you back home to make yourself clean, to keep yourself clean. So you have to come to school clean. At 8 o'clock, the school principal rang the bell, warning students that school would soon begin. Now, this is the scene of their school. You have to compare it with your school life, with your school morning assembly. Like at 8 o'clock, principal rang the bell, warning students that school would soon begin. When the bell began, we are struck that now it's time for morning assembly, and after morning assembly you have to go back to your classes. The next bell rang at 8:30 a.m. when the students got in line for assembly. Before assembly, the children played in the schoolyard. Among the games they played were hide and seek, jump rope, marbles, tops, yo-yos and kites. So these are the games which were played in the past. Now you have to think which games you played during your assembly hours. Before your assembly, you have, if you came early, you have 10 to 15 minutes before assembly, you are playing in the ground. What games do you play? What game do you like to play? So you have to think that in your mind. The games they used to play were hide and seek, jump rope, marble, tops, yo-yos, and they usually fight times, but you have to think which game, what games you used to play. Okay. Now, I have some questions for you guys, so you can think, and then I will take the answers from you at the end. But how's your morning? Is your morning same like the morning of Hamza and Taha, or is it different? Hamza and Taha, what Hamza and Taha used to do? They used to do household chores. Hamza used to draw water from the well, and Taha used to cut the vegetables. So what do you do before coming to school? Do you do the same thing or you do the different things? How is your morning different? If you don't do these kinds of work, what do you do? How is your morning different? This is the question you need to think and you have to answer me about this. So there's another question. Do you think the people or the children living before 60 years, were they happy with their life or they were not happy? In my opinion, I would say life was not easier in the past. They had to do a lot of work, a lot of household chores by themselves and before coming to school. And I'm talking about the children who come to school. The children who come to school in today's present day, they don't have to do these household chores. So their life is much simpler than the life of the children before 60 years. They had to do all their work by themselves, whether it is cooking, cleaning, washing, or dishing. All these things they had to do by themselves. Now, look at page number 13, simple past tense. As you have read this whole historical report, the whole report is written in the past because the events are held in the past. As report means, it should be related to the past events. So when you're writing about the past, you use past tense. What is past tense? Past tense is the things which are already happened in the past and we are now talking about them. The things which are already done in the past, for that we use past tense. Now see, most of the verbs in the passage are in simple past tense. They tell us about actions that were completed in the past. To form regular past tense verbs, there are two kinds of verb, regular and irregular. What are regular? In the regular verbs, we add ed at the end, like scaled, cleaned, washed. Clean is verb. And after that, we add ed in it. It is regular verb. Adding ed at the end of a verb, it becomes regular verb. And what is irregular verb? We just use the third form of the verb in it, like ate, broke. So they ate boiled eggs for breakfast. We haven't added ed in it because it is irregular verb. We will just say they ate. And when we say he scaled, we will use ed with it. He scaled and cleaned the pamphlets. Many verbs are irregular in the past, simple past tense. They ate boiled eggs for breakfast. Now, this will be your homework. I will mention it. Question number one is, find the simple past tense of these verbs in the passage. Now these are words. You have to read the whole passage again and you have to find the simple past tense. The simple past tense of these words like is, go, begin, make, do, grow, sell, bring, get. These are the words. These are the words for which you have to find the past tense in the passage. And the second one is, rewrite this passage in the simple past tense. This is the passage. You have to write it in the simple past tense. This is written in present tense. As you can see, Anna does the ironing and the boys get water from the well. This does, is, it means that this is written in present tense and you have to change it and you have to rewrite this whole paragraph in past tense. Do you get that? Simple past tense. You have to rewrite this paragraph into simple past tense. Now, what is past continuous tense? First, I have told you about simple past tense. It is just simple. Now, past continuous tense, that the verb which is ongoing in the past. Like, Amna was ironing the school clothes. With verb we add ing. Previously in a simple past tense we just add ed with the verb, but in the past continuous tense we add ing with it. Was ironing is a past continuous tense. it tells us what Amna was doing. What Amna was doing, she was ironing the clothes. This action was not yet completed. The past continuous tense is also called the past progressive tense. The meaning is same, but just the words are different. This tense uses the helping verb was and were. In the past tense, what we use was and were. Was is used for singular and were is used for plural. Was verb plus verb plus ing. Okay, we use was and were in past continuous tense, plus we add verb, use verb first form by adding ing. Were is used for plural, like we were playing. I was playing. Okay, I is singular and we is plural. So we use verb with plural words and was with singular words, and we add verb with ing. Any verb with first form, then we add ing at the end of it. It becomes past continuous tense, which is ongoing work which haven't been finished in the past. Like Amna was ironing the clothes. She was ironing the clothes. It hasn't mentioned here that she had done this work. She was ironing the clothes. The work is ongoing in the past. This tense used the helping verb was verb with the present participle. Present participle means that first form of verb. In a simple word, we can say first form of verb with plus ing with it. I was ironing, you were walking, he was reading, we were sitting. I was ironing, I is singular, so we will use was with it. And iron is first form present participle, and we will add iron plus ing, ironing. You were walking, walk is the first form present participle. You were walking, he was reading, he is singular, was plus we ke sath ing, reading. We were sitting, we is plural, for we is used for many people. So we used were with it, sit, and we will add ing at the end, sitting, will be sitting, we were sitting. So take out now page number 14. This question, the exercise of this question, we will do orally. Like, we have to write these sentences in the past continuous tense. Now I have explained you what is past continuous tense. I will ask you at the end what is past continuous tense. So, I was were plus help Teddy clean the fish. I was helping. I is singular. What we will use with it? Was. I was. Now it's help. See here. It's help. We will add ing at the end. I was helping Daddy clean the fish. Now the next is Mummy and Daddy was. No, Mummy and Daddy were, because they are two people. Mummy and Daddy were discussing. Discuss, at the end we will add ing. Mummy and Daddy were discussing the news with the neighbor. Next is the sun was. The sun was shining that movement. The sun was shining that movement. So now you have to practice this orally. You don't have to write it, or not on the book, not on the copy. Only this question you have to practice it. Now I am writing your homework over here. What you have to do. So your homework is on page number 13, question number 1 and 2. You have to do all this work in the book. And if you have any question or any query regarding this, you can see this whole lecture on the YouTube. The YouTube link will be mentioned and will be sent to you. So you can re-watch the lecture again on the YouTube channel. Page number 14, it's question number 2, and on page 15, question number 1 and 2. So this is your homework, home assignment. You have to do this in your book. On this book, all the work should be done on the book. Okay. And I will send you words meaning and words and tenses of this chapter on WhatsApp through school. Now, if you have any question, you can ask.